It's with a heavy heart, but with an absolute necessity and a determination to beat this Delta strain, just as we did a few weeks ago, that the Chief Health Officer and the Public Health team have recommended to me and my Cabinet colleagues that we lock Victoria down from 11:59pm tonight until 11:59pm next Tuesday night.
Just before 5pm, Victorian Premier Dan Andrews fronted up to announce the lockdown designed to quash the fast-spreading virus.
You only get one chance to go hard and go fast. If you wait, if you hesitate, if you doubt, then you will always be looking back wishing you had done more earlier. I am not prepared to avoid a five-day lockdown now only to find ourselves in a five-week or a five-month lockdown.
The snap announcement coming hours after this warning from the Victorian COVID Response Commander.
The situation is moving not so much hour by hour, but half hour by half hour.
6,500 Victorians are now isolating, contact tracers racing to detect the chains of transmission. Two of the cases in particular have officials concerned.
They were both sitting in level two in the members' reserve at the MCC. We do not believe that they are known contacts of the other two positive cases that we know were there.
This afternoon, the Prime Minister announced intentions to amp up the financial support.
I'll be putting to National Cabinet tomorrow what we think is more simple and streamlined set of financial supports for states and territories going forward.
The key change would see the liquid assets test waived for disaster payments of up to $600, which would now cover workers from the start of lockdown.
Payments for a COVID support payment would still be paid in the second week of a pandemic. They would be paid basically on an arrears basis on that first 7 days.
Well, there is need in Victoria from 11:59pm tonight. And we expect that the Commonwealth Government will step up and help those people who need that help.
As Victorians now join New South Wales in lockdown, Australia is again facing an uncertain future.
It's just the nightmare, isn't it? It really is. It's been a really flat day in Melbourne. And, you know, I think everyone's going to be moving their own furniture well into the future from now on. But you mentioned it in the intro, the Tale of Two Cities. We now have, I guess, a test case on how to deal with the Delta strain. We've seen Sydney do it their way, and Melbourne are going to try This way.
I don't know about you, and I don't know about you, Lise, as a Sydney-sider, but I felt there was something quite pointed in the way Daniel Andrews spoke about it today, that sort of like, we're not waiting. We know what happens when you wait. And that sounded like he was talking about Sydney. And there were constant references to the situation in Sydney, if not by name, throughout it. This is like a head-to-head experiment. It seems,
absolutely. Yeah. And this is, we didn't want to be the test case, but good on Daniel Andrews for recognising the mistakes that have been made here in New South Wales. And I mean, even today, even those cases being in the mid-60s, down from just over 100 2 days ago, that's a good sign. But the really worrying one continues to be the number of people who are still out there infectious in the community. And that doesn't seem to be shifting. And that's what we're all worried about.
Yeah, which is a big concern. We'll talk about that later in the show as well. But Georgia, you live in Melbourne. Like, do you reckon Victorians or Melburnians, it's statewide, but do you reckon Melburnians will feel more comfortable with a lockdown because of what happened in Sydney?
In Sydney, I think so. I think that there's a different feel to this lockdown even than the one that we had only a month or so ago or a couple of weeks ago, that two-week lockdown, because that one then felt the mood was a lot lower. This one, it's exasperation, of course, is still there. Yeah. But I think that people are seeing what's going on in New South Wales and being like, well, we've seen this, so we can do this. Interestingly, I'm just trying to get my head around Victoria was, for a brief few days, the sporting hub of Australia. We had all the AFL teams coming here. They're all leaving again. There's a couple of games that are still happen in Melbourne this round. No crowds, though, no community footy. The Super Netball's off to South Australia. And the Melbourne Storm, who were going to come back for their first round in Melbourne, they're back to Queensland.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.